Bum, 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 bum. All right, let's play horse. 13 days. 13 days until Return to Monkey Island comes out. I cannot wait. Comes out on Monday, though. I don't know if I'll be playing it day one, but I'll definitely be playing it that weekend. Probably streaming it. I don't know, actually. Where did we leave off? Still trying to find our family. Only 3 hours of playtime? That doesn't sound right. Maybe it is. Thought I had at least like 5 or 6. Oh, right. So now it's kind of open world. We can go to different cities, participate in getting jobs, getting money. We can use that job to like buy upgrades. Just make sure I remember what I'm doing. Yeah, okay. That. What does that say? Hungry Ghost? I'm guessing that's just an additional video game. That's right. We have to get into BCT, I think? Maybe? No? Ah, this is what happens if you don't play for like a week. You forget everything. Not supposed to go here quite yet. Look around. We just came from the train station. And we can go do some menial jobs here. Did we do all these? Yeah, we did. Alright, I guess we don't need to go here just yet. I have 4 tickets. I swear we were supposed to go in there, right? Let's go check that one more time. Maybe we missed something. I don't know if we're supposed to do anything with this. Let's try it. In. No. No. And it's a dead end. Yeah, okay. I don't think we're supposed to come here just yet. No. Nope, we can't do anything here. Alright, let's just go to the next town. I'm guessing at some point we can unlock these cargo holds, but right now they're kind of just there. Alright, we got 4 tickets. Let's go. Oh, where are we going? This way.
Mind the doors.
Oh, shit. I didn't mean to do that.
Mind the doors.
Not
the
minding
train
them.
Is now departing.
All right, so we came from Main Town, leaving Big City. We're going to Sitcombe. Sitcombe Bay. Sitcombe.
The train made its way to Sitcombe. I could get off here to find Alice.
All right. I guess we're finding Alice.
Sitcombe.
Alright. Anything over here?
Mind
no.
The doors.
Just death.
The train is now departing.
Yeah. Oh. Oh, I got something. Okay. Nothing. Nothing. Let's go left. Help wanted? Sure. Oh. Eh, we're fine. We don't need money right now. I guess we can't talk to anybody. Oh, that would kill me. Guessing maybe I'll get the ability to fly or walk on water. Wonderland.
It looks like I would need a ticket to get through the fairground's automatic doors.
Through here? No. Alright.
Now then, said the dirty old man, let's see what you've got. Impressive.
Oh, this is where you sell the safes.
I collect these. I collect these. Everything else is junk.
Thanks.
Go on then, said the younger man. Stick everything in Bertha.
Bertha has eyes. How much junk was that worth? Ooh! Okay, I never need money again. I need to find an upgrade place. The Little Woods. Oh, well, there it is. A shield? What does this do? How do I get the football results up with this thing? No, I don't want that. How do I get out of this? There we go. Insta-clean would be good. Spot danger from afar? No. Top of the range cleaning ability for your trusty Steptoe chip. Let's do that. Yep, we're doing that.
Clean even the largest junk in the blink of an eye. Great choice, sir. That costs 30,000.
Alright. Okay. Is there anything past that? No. I guess we could spend money on this stuff, right? Just to see what's back there? Yeah, let's do it. Buy all the cheap upgrades.
Restocking on shield orbs. Very wise, sir. That will be...
Unless it's only shield orbs. Oh, yeah, it's only shield orbs. Let's see what this is. How do I get the football TV remote? Sure. See what this does.
Television not included, sir.
Okay. Are we just buying junk? What did that do? What did that do? I don't even know. We're just buying trash. Ooh, what's this? Oh, another shield slot for 58? That might be worth it. But I kind of want to see what this binocular vision thing does. 15k. Spot danger from afar. Let's go with the extra shield.
An additional shield.
Let's do it. I don't think we need to spot danger from afar. We just need more shields. And now we're broke. Anything past that? Another shield slot. Huh. So is it 50k for each slot? Lazarus revived 111. Oh, have I really died 111 times? Seems a lot. Yeah, it seems like a lot. Yeah, so right now I can hold 3 shield orbs. Okay. I'm gonna go for the binoculars next time. Ooh, the arcade. We played all of this. Yeah, we played. Oh, Rhythm King? Did we play Rhythm King? I feel like we have. Yeah, I think we've done all of this. Yeah, let's get out of here. Alright, so we said we can find Alice. It's a church. Ooh. Flashback?
I was surprised to find Alice's house was a lot larger on the inside.
Sounds
and strangely, it lacked any color.
This is creepy. Anything over here? I don't think so. I didn't see anything. Yeah, no junk here.
Curiously,
oh,
this
God.
Was a ridiculous amount of stairs for such a small cottage.
Oh, this is freaky. Where is this taking me? This is freaky. Is it taking me back the way I came? I think it just did. Okay. Well, that was completely useless.
How strange everything was. I remember wondering if I had been changed in the night.
Tiny door.
Inside was a beautiful brightly colored field, but there was no way I could fit through such a tiny door.
Okay. Do I need a specific ability? Oh, what is this?
On the table was a large cake. I've
cake.
Never eaten anything before, but for some reason I felt compelled to have a taste.
Oh, I can float now. Yes! Oh, this is Flappy Bird. Ooh. Oh. Okay.
Suddenly, a large glass bottle appeared. I don't know if it was all the growing that I had been doing, but I felt like I needed a drink.
And now what? Oh, I'm tiny! Oh, shit. Oh, this is... Oh. Okay. Alright, let's try this again. Oh. Okay, now I see what the shield is for. So you don't have to be absolutely perfect. Ooh. Oh, I was trying to be safe about it. Yeah, it's recording all my deaths. I'm sure there are people that do a no-death run. I should probably take my time. Oh my god, what? Bring out this. Yeah. Let's use that shield. Oh, is this Mario? Oh, it is. Trippy Mario, though. Can I jump on you? Yeah, I can. Okay. Feels very much like Sonic or, get everything first. Oop. Another shield. Is that it? Oh, what? What is this? Oh, I don't want to go up here. Oh, shit. Alright, well, that's fine. Let's go this way. Can I jump on you? No, I cannot. Was I not supposed to pick up that mushroom? Kind of feels like I wasn't supposed to. Oh, damn it. Oh. Yeah, I think as long as I don't... Yeah, I don't think I need to actually get the mushrooms. Oh, what? Oh, yeah. That was pointless. That was pointless. Oh, I got boots. Oh, I didn't do anything. I didn't do anything that I wanted. Oh. Unless I'm supposed to collect the mushrooms. Did the music disappear? Oh, this is painful. Oh, right, water hurts me. Okay. Yeah, let's just grab the mushrooms. Why not? Supposed to do something here? Besides not die? What am I doing? What is the point of all this? I guess I could go this way. Yeah, okay. There we go. Oop. Oop, shit. Shit! Ow. All right. Now how do I get back down? Oh, got it. Ugh. Yeah, I definitely need a shield. Oh, this is difficult. Okay. What if I go this way? Oh, there's nothing this way. I have to go. Okay. Ugh. I need to always be running. Ugh. Oh, that instantly kills you. Jesus. All right. Okay. Oh, damn, I didn't mean to do that high of a jump. Okay. Good thing we have shields. Cause trying to finish. Nope. Oh, did I just lose both my shields? That's unfortunate. Normal jump it. Oh god. This is trippy. Ah, we made it. Okay. Dear lord. We're sitting on ourselves. What is going on? the door there. First I want to go... Let's go down. What's down? Oh, okay, it all goes back. Alright, we have no choice. We're going in our brain. Alright, let's store our shield for a minute. Try to figure this out. The hell? How do we get past that? Okay, we're blocked on both sides. What are we supposed to do? Go in the door upside down, maybe? I can't pick anything up. Try jumping on it. Nope, that didn't help. Oh, I see. Okay. We have to get Sonic over here to... Got it. I see. That's an interesting mechanic. There we go. Okay, this is cool. Yeah, okay. Alright, I get it. Oh, that's open now? Okay. Gotta be aware. Stage is changing. Okay. Okay, now they're all open. Alright. That was a lot. We're through. And I think that's it. Yeah. Oh no! Oh, this is very Mario Brothers. Oop. Oh, I don't know what happened. Okay, I'm running. This is trippy. I'm just gonna start me all the way at the beginning. No, nope. Alright, cool, first try. 1 hour wait from here? Really? What is this dude doing? 2 hour wait. Alright, he's just gonna follow me. That's fine. That's fine. 4 hour wait. That doesn't do anything. Alright, keep running. Keep running. Oh, I just barely missed. I don't think I need shields for this. Ooh, oh, I almost messed up. Let's go left. One thing I will say about this game. Nothing to see this way. Oh, we're going this way. Turn back. Definitely keeping you on your toes. Go enter one of the doors. Have a nice game of chess. Honestly, nothing to see. You'll be disappointed. It's probably truly nothing. See, it's just some sparks and you hate sparks. Yep. Alright, well, it was worth it. Left door. Oh, are we playing chess? Who are we trying to get? Are we trying to get you? Or are we trying to eliminate everybody? Let's try it. Nope. Okay. We're trying to avoid getting eliminated. Oh, no. You're a horse, so you can't do anything. Okay, I can eliminate people. Wait, was that it? What is this trippiness? Okay. Okay. Oh, that didn't work. What's above us? Anything besides death? It's like this is here for some reason. Okay, well. Oh, was I collecting stuff? Okay. Oh. Is this where we're going? Oh, towards the door? Yeah, towards the door. Okay, what is this madness? I can't go that way. Can't even go this way, actually. Oh, I have to make stuff move, right? Yeah. Alright, fake Sonic or whatever the hell this is. I actually can't do anything. Let's see. It's a cool castle. Maybe I have to, like, jump? No? No. Okay. That doesn't work. Yeah, it doesn't work at all. This is not helpful. Maybe I need to go through the right door. If I jump over here. There we go. Okay. Trippy. Oof. Okay. One, two, three. Okay. Then jump back to the other side. Yeah. Oh, okay. Jump. And we're here. What is this castle from? It's gotta be from some game, I just don't recognize it. Oh my god, we're playing an FPS. What is that in our hand? I can't even strafe. So a very primitive FPS. Let's see, what's the story it's telling? Okay, that's when we first met our father, I guess. Same on each side? Yeah. Yeah, same picture. Okay, we can run. And that was the guy that was like high on mushrooms. And then father had a heart attack. We took his hat. Part of the family. I was thinking maybe it was like Mario, where you have to jump through the painting. Yeah, that's all we can do is point. I guess there's gotta be like a switch somewhere. That's creepy. Oh, there's a door here. Before we do that, let's go explore the rest of the area. Oh, us against a robot. What is over here? So it's just memories? I mean, it makes sense. We're in our brain. What is this from? Alright, well that was it. So it has to be that door. Ugh, controls are a little wonky. Oh no, we're floating again. That's not gonna work. Is there a timer that shows us how much cake we have left? No. Well, I mean, that's one way of making it through it. This feels like EGA graphics. This is some Flappy Bird. Okay. Well, that's not very fair. Gotta wait. There we go. 2, 3. Yeah, it definitely looks like Sonic. Do I have to duck? I think I have to duck. Whoa. That was messing with me. Oh, it's like an RPG? Off with his head. What is going on? Ride the slopes and score big, but slums, moguls, and hidden treasure. Gym. Oh, Man, that camera shaking the TV is not cool. I'm never gonna get that. What score do I need to make? Being there. Fly free as a bee as you search for treasure and a way back home. Alright, at least we can like land. Oh, why are you shaking? The screen. That is going to hurt. Not a fan of the shaky screen. Ugh. Man, you're gonna make me puke here. Luckily, we have plenty of extra lives. Caddy, cross the road and get to the cats before the steamroller does. Alright, so we're playing Frogger. Oh, I thought it was like tile-based. Oh, we gotta bring him back. Got it. Oh god, you're terrible. Ugh. And now you're blocking the way, too? That is rude. Did it. Mostly. There we go. Last adventure, Densetsu. Save the kingdom from the evil queen. Oh, we're playing Final Fantasy. Or Zelda? Zelda. Use this to light your way. The caves are perilous without it. So we can't attack. Oh, we gotta go this way. Got it. The Holy Ice Sword. Some monster will freeze at its touch. Also deflects projectiles. Hey. Okay. Now what? I guess we weren't supposed to go back. Maybe? To do here. Nope, that wasn't supposed to happen. Oh, there's an area over here. Didn't realize you were blocking it. Explode that dynamite somehow. Magic key! Oh, let's go unlock it. Let's go unlock that door. What's over here? More stuff? More lamp, oil. Ooh. Oh. Door. Wand of fire. Okay. Now I can blow up the dynamite. Okay, got it. I shouldn't have done that. Oh, is that what I'm supposed to do? Bullet hell action here. Hey. I get a crown because I beat the game within the game.
"Look who I found at the train station," said a distant voice. For some reason they were all dressed as wizards. "Oh my god," shouted the voice.
"Stop!"
Alice explained what was going on, while the man swiftly put my head back together. "And this is Simeon," said Alice. The man insisted I called him Sim, and apologized for attempting to hack my CPU.
And he has
and
COVID.
Said, "Sorry, Sim tends to sneeze whenever he's stressed or nervous. I was worried you were like other robots. I'm glad you're okay, though. I've had mixed results in the past."
"Aw."
"This is Betty," said Sim, "and this idiot is Fluffers."
"Fluffers."
"It's like they're our children," said Alice. "Although it's strange, it was them that sort of found us. And even before Sim had reprogrammed them, they were kind of nice to me. Betty even tried to clean up some of my rubbish." "So," said Mr. Silton, "the reason we're visiting is our little robot friend wants to see Heather and her mum again. Plus he tells me that there's some sort of problem with escaped nanobots in the old house."
"Achoo!"
Alice looked puzzled. "What do you need me for then?" she said. "I'm assuming you've not broken the habit of a lifetime and thrown away Sim's security pass." Sim smirked at Alice. "It'll be here somewhere." Mr. Silton smiled. "Excellent," he said. "Then I presume you've still got that video camera you stole when you were working on Richard and Judy." Sim guided us down a set of basement stairs. "Well, thanks to Alice's quirky hobby," he sighed as he flicked a light on, "we've still got everything."
"Jesus."
Mr. Silton smiled. Then, he said, "I think I've got a plan."
"Achoo!"
Didn't they rob people and kill people? Who in the world am I? Ah, that's a great puzzle. Lewis Carroll. Chapter 8, Beyond Wonderland.
"Although I would have loved to have stayed in Alice's picturesque town, it was time to get back on the train and continue my quest."
Is there anything in here that I can take? No? Wait a minute. Hold on a second. What is this? What can I do here? Oh. Yeah, we can mess with that later. Yeah, nothing here. Back on the train. Yeah, how did we get up there? We had to figure... Close gate after use. Yeah, I gotta figure out how to close the gate, I guess.
It looked like I would need
have
a ticket to get through the fairground's automatic doors.
Don't really need your help. And we're not close enough, even with the max junk upgrade. Alright, well, let's go somewhere else. I gotta make sure to go through every cart. All junk there. Okay, we got all the junk. Alright, going to Factory Town. Factory Town. Oh man. Load star, comma A, comma 1. And what is it, like L, comma, list the files? Yeah. I thought it was like L, shift 8 or something like that.
This is Factory Town.
Factory Town. How you doing, Lucidius?
Cold specks of rain began to fall as I stepped off the train onto the deserted platform. The station looked as if it hadn't been used in years. There were no conductors, no ticket barriers, not even an up-to-date timetable. The place was like a ghost town.
Yeah, this game, I don't know if you just got in, Lucidius, is super all over the place. In a good way. There was like a Frogger type level, there was a first person mode, there was a Flappy Bird level. It's kind of just like everything. I don't think there's anything over here, right? Yeah, just death. Very well, thanks. How was your Labor Day weekend? It was good. We actually took an overnight trip and drove about an hour west of us over to Harper's Ferry, which is like a historic little center in West Virginia. Yeah, wasn't too bad. First time I've ever been there. My wife is from the area, but the last time she was there was maybe in like middle school. So yeah, first time catching it. Looks interesting. Classical music, references to Commodore. I mean, that's a good start for me. Yeah, references to a lot of like 80s and 90s. Things, Commodore 64, Outrun, Space Harrier, Frogger, Flappy Bird, Pac-Man. Yeah, it's basically a huge, huge love letter to that era of video games. Where are we supposed to go? We're leaving. We're at Factory Town. We have 2 tickets left. Ben-Hur, Rambo of the Bailey? What? I can't do anything with water just yet. Can I do, like, right here? Oh. Ooh, that almost killed me. Oh, that's where I was at. I think this is just, like, your standard... Yeah, I've done all these little menial... Yeah, little side missions here. Like, little rhythm games to earn money for upgrades. Can I get that from here? No, I can't. Okay, that's fine. Yeah, I guess we need an upgrade so we can actually go through water without dying. Convenient conveyors. Love that 80s synthesized voice. Yeah. Yeah. It is pretty good. The music is definitely a little trippy in this particular level. Oop. 90,000 junk, only 910,000 more. Hold on a second. My dog is whining. Need to get out of speak and spell. Wow, I haven't heard about a speak and spell in quite some time. But yes. Yeah, definitely a love letter to those of us who grew up in the 80s and 90s. Kind of want to get a Commodore 64, like, emulator. I think that'd be fun to try out. We're going this way. There's no way we're gonna get 1,000,000 junk. This game wants you to get 1,000,000 junk. I don't see that happening. Wait, was that what we were supposed to do? Was that it? I guess that was it. Wonder what it loads. I've tried a couple of different commands. I couldn't get it to load anything in particular. It just gave me snarky responses to everything I tried to do. Oh, I need to somehow make it to the other side of the conveyor belt. Okay, let's do that. I missed something, barely. Oh, right, the door. I missed the door. Yeah, next time I'm in the area, I'll try it. It gives you a list of commands. I'm sure there are some secret commands that we can try. I just couldn't remember them off the top of my head. It's been so long since I've done any sort of typing on a Commodore 64. Definitely has some difficulty spikes. For the most part, it's pretty chill. And then every so often, it goes off the deep end. Oh. What does this do? Oh, shortcut. I wanna go here? I could be going through that door though. There we go. Ooh, that's... Oh, it's just back the way we came. Okay, let's go back. Ooh, that almost happened. Almost happened. Alright, we're back. Cleaning professional. Achievement unlocked. You know I like achievements. Me up. Okay. All right, let's try this again. Oh. I mistimed that. Okay. Oh, we got a shield. Not that we've been using it. Let's use our shield. Let's stop being tryhards. See? Exactly. I want to go back and get my shield. There we go. What's the point of having shields if we're not going to use them? This is not a no-hit run. Dropping? Okay, we weren't supposed to do that. We weren't supposed to do that. We just fell off the face of the earth. Let's try that again. It starts us back all the way over here. It's not cool. So we jump across. Okay. Do we jump and fall that way, I guess? No way. Huh? Maybe we do. It looks like it. I think we do. Yeah. Yep, okay. Well, let's get this trash first. Anything over on this side? Nope, death. Solomon Automatons. Yeah, the pixel art on this is so good.
The security system jumped to life. I knew the only way I could deactivate it was to destroy its power source. That's when I spotted a perfect shiny surface. Maybe I could deflect one of the lasers toward the generator.
Okay. Alright, what laser? Oh, okay, that laser? Hold on, let's just hit the button. Oh, okay. Ooh. Okay, I just gotta make sure I don't kill myself. Probably have to use yellow, right? Nah, I don't. Let's turn everything off. But what about that mirror right there? Hold on a second. What does that do? What is that? Yeah. Hold on. I want to test something here. Probably gonna kill me. Oh. Okay. Was I supposed to use those? I have no idea. The door's open. Who cares? The door is open. I don't see anywhere else to go.
Mr. Silton and the others arrived and changed out of their disguises. Although Mr. Preston was mourning, as apparently Mrs. Silton had only washed his and Mr. Logan's Halloween costumes.
Alright, Mr. Silton, what do we do? These maps kind of remind me of the maps that we saw in, is it Crazy Ed from Maniac Mansion? Kind of shows the layout of the hotel. Or not the hotel, the mansion. Okay. I guess we're going through one or the other. Go through yellow. Oh, it's showing us where we're going. Oh, oops, I completely missed that. Well, that didn't help. Oh, here we go. Here's the Commodore 64. Right, so we type help. Close data, stim, list. Nothing to see. Yeah, I thought it was like L comma or L shift 8 or something like that. No. Yeah, I don't think there's actually any games here. Or if they are, they're a secret. Log. Yeah, just snarky comments. Status. Sin. Sloth. Run. What's the urgency? Yeah. Fake Commodore 64. Len. Steal my sunshine. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. If you do a load, nothing happens. No. Be more specific. Oh, maybe. Load game. Oh, okay. File. Load. Ending. Load star. Oh, it's doing something. Oh, okay. Oh, so it just loads the arcade. Dance Invader. So if I type in, like, load Dance Invader... Oh, right, I gotta do quotes. Oh, that works. I bet you there's some secret games. Cool. Look at that. We learned something today. Alright, what are we doing? I guess we're just going.
The office was deserted, but it looked like people had left in a hurry. Various computers had been left on.
I do not know what this vending machine is supposed to be used for. Or this. Now let's go back to the first door right here, the cafe, I guess. That brings us to the top. Hungry Ghost, we played all this. All junk cleared. Alright, now we're in the bathroom. All junk cleared. Dead end. Second door?
Strangely, there were drawings of me everywhere. I hope the professor could tell me why when we found him.
Oh, I gotta get up there? Yeah. Going on here. Like getting junkers are an actual purpose. Yeah, I do not know what this okay, sure. Yep, just junk. Okay. Back to the door. Ooh.
There were no signs of life. If the professor was living here, he hadn't been here in a long time.
What is going on?
This all looked very familiar. I would have looked around more, but we needed to find the professor.
What about this way? So we're just getting junk. Alright, and then back this way. Doors.
It's strange. None of the machines were totally active, but the power was still on.
Okay. Oh. Okay, so this is where we came from. Did we go left? No, we didn't. How do I get to the left here? Let's see. Bring you back down. So this brings me to the what? To the right? Okay. Does this take me? Oh, new location. Another dead end bathroom? Yeah. Okay. See, we diverted more than enough. Now where? Back the way we came? Probably. Ooh. Damn it. There we go. So if we go here, that takes us up. So we need to find a way to go to the right. 14 jump combo, huh? Love it. Yeah, I don't know if that actually means anything. Maybe we get extra cash? I'm not sure. Oh. Oh!
I didn't want to leave without Mr. Silton.
What? Oh, we gotta go back. Okay. Well, how do we bring Mr. Silton, though? That takes us up. Hold on, let's go back. And then to the left. Yes. Where does that bring me? I think it's a dead end, right? It's the bathroom? Yeah. Let's go to the next door. Alright, then Mr. Silton is over here. Oh, shit. How many deaths? 137? Yeah. So maybe I need to figure out how to turn off power. That's probably what it is. Yeah. Go here. Hmm. Is there anything else I need to blow up? I don't think so. Yeah, I don't think so. Hmm. Maybe let's go back through things? Maybe we're missing. Oh, here we go. Okay. Okay, he's following us. Okay, so I do need to figure out how to turn off power. Oh, okay. Gotcha. Gotcha. I need to make a bridge for them. Nope. Okay, never mind. That's not what I'm supposed to do. What am I supposed to do? Yeah, I don't know what this is supposed to be for. Okay, how do I get them across? Bathroom. Bathroom. We've been here. I'm getting some hoagie Day of the Tentacle vibes from the Metalhead NPC following you. Yeah. I need to replay that game. That was such a fun game. Yeah, I don't have all the puzzles memorized on Day of the Tentacle, but Maniac Mansion, I can pretty much just about finish with my eyes closed. Motion sickness incoming. Hey, Varanor. Yeah. Yeah, the perspective changes on this game are definitely a little off-putting, especially if you're going around like little tight corners. Let's see. There we go. Okay. I guess that's what I'm supposed to do? Oh, yeah. Okay. Now I know what. Now I know what they're asking me. I do have to make a bridge. It's way too fast. Yeah. Especially if I'm running. Oops. Now I've got it. Hold on, I need to get the long piece. Yeah. Oh. Yeah, I've gotten used to it for the most part. Come on, team. Grab this. You guys coming? Metal. He's such an old school metalhead. So we're just escorting people now. Sometimes I accidentally change perspective. That messes me up. Okay. Oh, I need to jump. Okay. Is this the right way? I think that's the right way. There we go. Ugh. Doc Martens in a flannel tied around your waist. The 80s and 90s were pretty rad. Yep. Yeah, it was. I could never pull off that look. Alright. Should be with me? Yes. Yeah, the flannel. The flannel was iconic. Wait, are we going this way? No, we are not. Going to the right. As far as I know. There we go. Oh, a puzzle.
A large piece of machinery blocked our path. Mr. Silton smiled when I asked what we should do next. I knew straight away that he didn't mean Mr. Preston or Mr. Logan when he said, someone's gonna have to climb inside. It seemed we could use the computer to move chunks of the machine around. I knew I needed to make a clear path, as it would be me that would be going through it.
Okay. Oh, okay. Where do I need to go, exactly? Oh, just... Oh, God. These puzzles. Sliding puzzle. Yeah, I'm not good at sliding puzzles. I'm guessing it needs me to use all the pieces. Alright, and I already completely messed that up. Oh, I see it. Yeah, I don't really care about getting that junk, so I'm just going to kind of ignore it. Like that. Hold on. So I need one of those top pieces, right? Maybe. Oh, wait. Wrong order, I think. Yeah. Um, Oh god. I know what I need to do. Like that? I think I got it. That's how it's supposed to be. Oh my god. I mean, if it's paying homage to the 80s and 90s, you pretty much have to include a sliding puzzle. Yeah, or like a box puzzle. If I do that... I don't really have anything for that. No, that's useless. There's a way to do this. I think this is it, right? Yeah, there we go. Cool. I think that works. Can we get anything while we're here? No. But that's fine. Yeah, it's fine. Yep, let's go. You can collect all 1 million junk if you miss those little alcoves. Probably not. Probably not. I imagine there's exactly 1 million pieces of junk. Turn that off so I never have to do that again. And everyone should be coming along, right? Yeah. Yeah, because I've got 121,000 after, what, 4 hours of play? I think this is about a 10 to 14 hour game. All right. Okay. Where's red at? Oh, okay. Red's over there. Nope. That was bad timing. What am I supposed to do here? Okay, so let's do this side first. Ooh, this. Oh, I guess I gotta have to put it like that? Yeah. And then. No? Oh, you know what. Okay, let's do that. Then we'll adjust that. Right, and we'll adjust that. Okay. Oh, I got to adjust the red back, damn it. Come on, team.
As we entered the extravagant corridor, the most beautiful tune played in the distance. But almost as soon as we began to enjoy its dulcet tones, the music stopped, dead.
Hmm. No idea where this emote came from, but it seemed appropriate. Does that say Puzzle God? Yeah, I think it does. Yeah, I don't know where that emote came from. Or how often the team had used. I think that's the first time I've ever seen it used. Come on, team. Let's go. Alright, we're at the end? Yes, the CEO. Oh, he's dead. He's been shot.
The professor was dead, but everything seemed wrong. He was old, very old, maybe 20 years older than when I'd last seen him. Mr. Silton sounded very sad when he said, "How did anyone even get in here? I don't know what to do now. I suppose we'll head back to the train station."
That was it? All that madness for nothing? Please fast travel us.
It was hard to believe the professor was gone. Although he was always suspicious of me, I was sad to think I'd never see him again.
Why is this dude not... There he is. Like, why are you not coming with me? Do we really... Okay, I was about to say.
Yes, it is. This is the right day, said the professor as he jabbed at a small metal box. I don't know how much time I've got
time
to explain,
traveler.
He continued as a bright light began to surround everyone.
Mr.
Oh,
Silton.
Not long at all.
Slowly backing away. Oh, did we get to play him? No, we don't. Nope, still a cutscene. Yeah, put a little weight on that metalhead guy, and that's Hoagie. What is with the obelisk?
We had reappeared just as smoothly as we had left, but we were somewhere very different. Mr. Preston and Mr. Logan were speechless, but the professor just continued studying his box. Looking back, I suppose I was rather stupid, as I ended up chasing a beautiful butterfly. I was lost, but soon I realized I wasn't as alone as
oh.
I thought.
Oh. Of course I would drink right when I'm being chased. Run!
I couldn't believe we had time traveled, but there was no time to sightsee. This was one of the most valuable things I'd seen.
Oh. Oh, damn. Okay. No room for error.
Historic world looked like paradise, except for the killer caveman.
That's it. Yes, except for the killer caveman.
I didn't know how much this was worth, but it looked expensive. I would have liked to have a look around.
I don't like that. I don't like how you have to hold up. It should like automatically grab.
This seemed quite valuable.
Oops. Oh. Whoa. Yeah, Space Odyssey. Oh, don't touch it.
After literally 10 minutes of Mr. Preston and Mr. Logan saying, "Whoa," and "Dude," the professor began to explain, "Time travel, if I can find the correct point in time, then I should be able to, well, make things better. I suppose it's like we're in that excellent movie," chuckled Mr. Logan. "Back to the Future?" replied Mr. Preston. "No, that excellent movie. Back to the Future 2? Time Bandits. Time Cop. Terminator.
I couldn't watch Time Groundhog Bandits. Day. It's too British
Groundhog
for me.
Day. Groundhog Day. The box let out a loud bleep as the professor gave it a heavy thump. This damn thing's so dependent on the maths used to calculate where the Earth is at any one point in time and space, that it's almost random where we'll end up, or even how long the time window will stay open. That last one was the shortest I've had yet. Although obviously apprehensive of our situation, I think Mr. Preston and Mr. Logan were too excited to really pay attention. But they were far less excited when I asked what his longest stay was, and the professor replied, about 15 years. I was stranded in ancient Egypt for so long. They had me build them a steam-powered robot. You should have seen the things they had it build. Yes,
the pyramids.
It was like I was Loth incarnate, or the modern Prometheus. Speaking of which, robot, have a look around, see if you can find anything to make a fire.
Yeah, British humor can get pretty out there. Yeah. Yeah, outside of like some Monty Python and a few different movies, I generally don't watch like British TV.
As great as my shoes were, they weren't much use when there was nothing for them to stick to. I rolled deep into the cave, but at least I had found the professor some firewood. Now I just needed to get back to everybody.
His smile
else.
Is great. Alright, we got firewood. This music actually reminds me of Stardew Valley a lot. Oh my god!
It may seem ridiculous, but I really did fall this far into the cave.
Oh no. Is there anything on the other side? Anything below me? I think I'm just gotta climb up. Okay.
Things started to look familiar. I was pretty sure I was nearly back where I had originally fallen. Everybody warmed themselves by the fire. In the orangey glow, the cave even looked a little homely. Mr. Logan was much more comfortable now that he could see his surroundings, but Mr. Preston kept saying, "We're in bloody dinosaur times." The professor laughed. He pointed out that there were 65 million years between dinosaurs and the emergence of man. But that just made Mr. Preston panic about possible dinosaur ghosts. I got the feeling Mr. Logan had heard this kind of talk before, as he sighed when he said, "Oh, I suppose you believe in ghosts as well now, do you?" "Well, yeah," said Mr. Preston. "Barry's missus says this bloke who works with her uncle reckons his brother saw one. Fact." And with that, he began to tell the most amazing story I had ever heard. He explained how there was a man traveling through the Black Wall Tunnel, who saw a young motorcyclist stood by a smashed-up motorbike. The man stopped, so the motorcyclist told him an address, but when he got in the back of the car, he fell silent. Clearly in shock. "This isn't a ghost story," interrupted Mr. Logan. "This is called giving someone a lift." Mr. Preston was annoyed. Mr. Logan's stupid joke had ruined his train of thought. The brother of a bloke who works with Mrs. Silton's uncle gave a young motorcyclist a lift after a crash outside the Black Wall Tunnel, I said, just happy to be part of the conversation.
"Good job, horse."
"That's it," said Mr. Preston as he explained that when the man arrived at the address, the motorcyclist had vanished. He said the man, not knowing
what else
to do,
knocked on the door of the house. "Feeling lazy tonight, new game though. I might end up checking this one out. All right, listen, thanks for stopping in. I'll catch you later. Enjoy your takeout."
She had a son. She burst out crying and sobbed, "I did have, but he died 10 years ago today, just outside the Black Wall Tunnel." Dun, dun, dun. I couldn't believe my audio senses. This was concrete proof of the afterlife. I mean, Mr. Logan did point out that the story was from a children's TV show called Grange Hill. But you can't argue with the facts. Soon, the professor had finished inputting whatever data his box needed. Robot, he said, we need to be outside for my computations to be truly accurate. Find us an exit from this platonic allegory. The cave. Find us a way out.
Plato's cave. Okay. Where do I even go? Oh, oops. Thought that was just background. Oop. Oh, okay. Well, that happened. Guessing this is the way to go. Oh, damn it. Nope. Okay, now I'm rushing. Oh my god. I don't know what I was trying to do. There we go. That's what I was trying to do. Oh, that was close.
This block looked perfect, so I decided I would only place it where the professor said I should.
Okay. Can I jump over that? Okay. Wait, where should I place it? Oh, okay, we're making a bridge. Got it. Got it, got it, got it. Go that way. Have to climb up. Oh no, that didn't work. Oh, wait, did I get it? I got it. I don't know how I'm gonna get this across. Yeah. Oh, I can jump? Oh, I can run and jump? There we go. I didn't realize I could run with this. Next up, on that side. Cross. Okay. One more? Where's the other one at? I feel like it's, oh, it's over there. I see it. How do I get over there? Oh, oop. Damn it. Okay, I know where. I'm guessing it's giving me shields because it's telling me I suck. Oops. Which, kind of true. Keep sliding. Ah! I didn't... keep thinking I'm not that close to it, but it just drags me in. Take our time. See? Oh, Lord. Yeah, and we got it. How to get this down? This? I mean, I was hoping it would be easy. Other way? This way. Okay. And we're good.
Well, I've reversed the polarity of the neutron flow, so, here we go, said the professor as the glowing light surrounded us again.
There's time traveling all over the place.
This is it, said the professor as he looked around. Oh no, he gasped as his expression became far more serious. It's the wrong time.
It's like Quantum Leap.
We had appeared in another barren desert. I was beginning to think that the past was made of nothing but sand. The professor looked concerned as he examined his box. It was then that we realized we were completely surrounded.
Oh, we're back in Egypt.
The men seemed to think I was some kind of god, or, as it turned out, some kind of sacrifice.
Okay. What am I supposed to do with this?
The stalactite above me looked quite unstable, like it was ready to come down.
Oh, I see. Okay. Alright. Oh, this way. Wait a minute, this way. Paying attention. Trying to make sure I landed on this stalactite. more shields. Oh, there we go.
As I got to the top of the cliff, I could see everyone else being led away in heavy chains. Their extravagantly dressed capturers were only moving them in a slow march, so I followed them at a safe distance.
Sorry, Logan, how are you, Preston? Oh, did you see me?
Strangely, the men seemed to ask the professor something, who nodded in agreement. Although they clearly knew each other, the man in charge pushed the professor into a small wooden cage, along with Preston and Logan. The men then left. I was about to attempt to free my friends when one of the men returned with some tools. It was then I heard some machinery start in the distance, and the man left again. I then found out what the machinery was.
It's a steam robot. Wait, what am I supposed to do? Oh, okay. Got it. Oh, okay. Just trying to figure out, like, what actually can hit me. What are you doing? Okay. That's not gonna work. Okay. Nope. Alright, I need to wait for him to get lower. Yeah. Okay. Oh, I should be on the side. Maybe I should. Oh no. That didn't work. Did it? Got him. Preston.
Mr. Preston took a chance to do something I'm guessing he thought was brave, shouting, "Catch you later, you ancient Egyptian dickweeds."
Good job, Mr. Preston.
This looks right.
Stay here,
whispered the professor, just in case.
Oh, he's about to whoop some ass. That's scary. Oh, damn.
Sorry to take you on a less than excellent adventure, whispered the professor, his voice slowly weakening. But I knew Ian needed to see these things. I was always worried about the military possibilities, but I'm pleased to see your consciousness software is still growing. Life is a state of mind. I had no idea what he meant, but he looked so happy.
Quick, shouted Mr. Logan, hide.
I jumped into a large cupboard with Mr. Preston, who whispered something about seeing some people on the security monitor. The cupboard door was pretty thick, so I couldn't really hear what was going on, but suddenly I heard Mr. Silton shout, "Run!" When Mr. Preston eventually opened the door, we saw a large glowing light, exactly like the one from the professor's time machine. It was only then that I realized that we had reappeared just before we had left.
Okay.
As we walked back to the train station, Mr. Silton was truly confused. All he kept saying was, "What the bloody hell happened?"
Hmm. Was this old Mr. Preston or young? Nothing is too high for the daring of mortals. We storm heaven itself in our folly. Chapter 9. I think this is actually a good
stopping
point.
Soon we were all gathered around the dusty blackboard back at Mr. Silton's house. He was explaining what was an increasingly complicated plan. And that, ladies and gentlemen, he said, is the plan of the century.
So, what are they going to do? What is going on? Trust me, I'm a celebrity. So there was a distraction.
Tim explained that Heather and her mom were in Lab 33. He said I should find them then take them to the gate on the other side of the base. I nodded, even though I must have looked terrified. I'll need to register these two, he continued. Hopefully the guards won't notice I walked in with three robots and now only have two. He wished me luck and reminded me it was Lab 33, that you only need to tell a robot something once.
That is very true. Okay, yeah, it is 7 o'clock. So we're stopping on Chapter 9. 120,000 junk. 156 death. Damn. Didn't realize that was that bad. Alright, everybody. Thanks for hanging out. I hope you enjoyed the game. I'm really enjoying it. I am glad I bought this game. I can't even remember how I found it. But yeah, the trailer just sold me on it. We'll be back on Thursday. So everyone have a good night.